Hey, what are you doing? Are you here to check out some chemistry with me, Mr. Dodson?
I hope so. Here, I'm in the chemistry lab, hoping to complete the fourth experiment, determination of an equilibrium constant. And of course, it's my hope you'll pay close attention to each and every step of the procedure that I show you, in particular, taking note of any observations, any data, so that you can complete this experiment on your own. Best of luck. Enjoy. Let's see what we got going on. Ah, yes. Here I have my three burettes with three aqueous solutions I'll be using shortly. I have my beakers, my flasks, I have my LabQuest, and the SpectroVis Pro. Hey, I know you add this all together and it represents a great time. So I've taken the time to clean and condition each of three burettes. The burettes contain three solvents we'll be using in this experiment. 1 times 10 to the minus 3 molar potassium thiocyanate, 0.200 molar iron 3 nitrate, and lastly the 0.50 molar nitric acid. In producing, of course, these three burettes, I would have produced waste. That waste has been collected into a waste beaker. Note the reddish-orange color of the iron thiocyanate complex being produced in this experiment. So, I'm going to begin by preparing my 5 standard solutions according to the procedure. I'll be adding the potassium thiocyanate, the iron 3 nitrate, and lastly the nitric acid to each of 5 flasks, producing 5 different concentration solutions, my 5 standards. I've produced the 5 standard solutions. Clear from the white background that these 5 solutions vary in concentration from most concentrated to least concentrated. In the beaker, I have the nitric acid solution. As I've already indicated, we're using nitric acid as a solvent, and as such, we want to be sure to use nitric acid for our blank when it comes time to calibrate the SpectroVis probe. Let's get started, shall we? I'll start by taking my most concentrated sample of the potassium thiocyanate complex. I'm going to place that into the SpectroVis probe, and I then go to the LabQuest, hit play, and hopefully get a nice looking spectrum. Alright, looks good to me. Let's go ahead and hit stop. And there we go. That would be our spectrum, which of course you'd want to sketch into your lab notebook. Note the absorption maximum is in the blue, as you would have expected, at a wavelength of about 447 nanometers. What we do want to do right now is quickly find that wavelength of maximum absorption. And so we're going to click on the table button and scroll down until we find the maximum absorbance. Let's see. 657. It looks like the maximum occurs right around 454.3, 455.1, 456. Let's take the maximum at 455.10. So the next thing we want to go ahead and do is return to the meter and introduce the wavelength we just recorded as 455.10. And we're going to change the mode from full spectrum to events with entry. We'll discard the data, and there we have the absorption of 0.653 at the wavelength maximum, 455 nanometers. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and record this, not so much in a notebook, sadly, I don't have one, at 0.652. I'm going to go ahead and pull out this sample and put in the next concentrated sample. The Q of S have already been wiped down. And I have 0.483 as in the absorption. I'll go ahead, pull out that sample, and put in the next concentrated sample. Record the absorption of 0.40. Boy, my hand is shaking. Is that crazy or what? All right. I'm laying the phone down. 405. Looks like I picked the wrong time to lay out the airplane glue. Next concentrated sample, 0.236. We'll pull that out and go with the least concentrated sample, 0.112. And of course, really important to us here, we want to record the absorbance of the blank. I have for the blank 0.008. And so that's my five values right there. I have 0.652, 0.483, 0.405, 0.236, 0.112, 0.008. For the second part of the experiment, we'll find ourselves producing the complex in this beaker right here. We'll produce the complex at various concentrations and measure the absorbance of those solutions using the spectrophysics probe. Then, of course, using that Beer-Lambert plot we produced a moment ago, it becomes possible to work out the concentration of the complex based on the measured absorbance. So first things first, we're going to produce a dilute solution of the potassium thiocyanate and a separate solution of the iron 3. So, here I'm getting ready to start the second part of the experiment. I've prepared my dilute solution of potassium thiocyanate, to which I will be adding 1 milliliter aliquots of the iron 3, which is also prepared in the small beaker next to it. And then, of course, we have the mystery spot. God only knows what that is. All the more important, we clean up spills as we see them. So, I'll be pipetting 1 milliliter of the iron 3 into the potassium thiocyanate. Important tech tip, really important to do this on a white piece of paper. The white paper provides a color contrast, making the color all that much easier to see. And there we go. Notice the orange color is formed as I deliver the iron 3. Ooh, fun chemistry. Touch the tip. Then I'll go about swirling to produce a nice homogeneous mixture. And it's from the solution that I'll draw an aliquot for the purpose of measuring the absorbance. There's the aliquot of my solution. I'm going to go ahead and place it into the spectrophysics probe. And I have a measured absorbance of 0.129. I'll call it a 9. As a reminder, for this part of the experiment, you're going to find yourself taking that solution we just prepared and pouring it back into the beaker. We'll then add another 1 milliliter aliquot of the iron. Okay, so I've added a second milliliter. The solution is slightly darker, and I expect to see as much when I measure the absorbance. What was 0.129 before is now 0.226. I take the solution and pour it back into the beaker, and we'll repeat the process. I'll add another 1 milliliter aliquot of the iron, stir to mix, and measure the absorbance. So, that's with 3 milliliters added. We go back, place it into the spectrophotometer probe, and measure the absorbance as being 0.289. So 4 milliliters added, I hope you can see the solution's obviously darker than it was with 1 milliliter added. With each aliquot of iron 3 added, that's more thiocyanate complex being formed. And of course, we expect to see in turn a greater absorption of light. Here, 0.346. There, the fifth and final milliliter added, the solution is significantly darker than it was to begin with. And now, of course, we can go ahead and place this in the spectrophotometer probe to record the absorbance for the fifth and final volume added. Have a measured absorbance of 0.380. That's it.